thought that by round five of the Mighty Ten Cup that neither Southland nor Hawke's Bay have a win between them. Their seasons have a similar look to them, with some good starts, poor finishes, the occasional close game and a thumping here and there. Time for that to change for one of these teams in order to celebrate the mid-season point with a smile, not a frown. Plenty of smiles in the crowd here as the numbers building up very nicely on a beautiful evening in Invercargill, awaiting their heroes to take the park, and they'll take on these players. And after the capitulation against Canterbury, it's no surprise that a raft of changes have been made, with the personnel cards shuffled eight times. Ash Dixon's back at hooker, with Ricky Riccatelli moving to the loose head. Mark Abbott returns to lock, with Trent Boswell-Wakefield starting on the blindside flank. Fa'alaminga Selizeli starts in eight. Brad Webber has the honours at halfback. Robbie Fuin returns, and Jonah Lowe is at centre. Ryan Tongia drops to a strong-looking bench. Four more black, John Preston again in the co-pilot's chair.
Yes, thank you, Tom, and welcome to Thursday Night Football, everyone. I know both these sides will be feeling the heat under pressure, but maybe it's time to throw off the shackles. A Hawke's Bay team flush full of talent, a couple of close losses, and we know what they can produce on a rugby field, and a Southland team at home that will be dead keen to nudge their first win.
Yes, Hawani McDonald's also rung many a change to find a winning combination. Backer Whareanui Hawara and Mike Murphy from injury. Taua Sossi Tuamavavi replaces Mike Malloy on the right wing. Phil Holder runs on in the number 7 jersey, and Matt Phillip regains a locking berth. Joe Walsh gets first crack at prop, with the impact of Benny Aravi safer later in the day. Brumbies halfback Mitchell Dowsett is a new recruit coming off the bench. More experienced is our sideline eye today, Calvin Middleton, enjoying the conditions.
Why, thank you, Tom. Yeah, stunning day. Conditions nigh on perfect. Ground is exceptional condition. There's a slight breeze that'll be favouring the team from the left running to the right. But I tell you what, both teams will be looking forward to getting a W behind their name.
Yeah, life's proving tough in the premiership for the Magpies, but so it should. The elite company has exposed weaknesses yet to be rectified. A loss in what is Hawke's Bay's sixth game could cut them adrift of the pack, with a return to the championship highly likely, which should be motivation enough to arrest the decline. Tasman, Manawatu and Waikato, their next opponents. No easy games there to enjoy or look forward to. And with their season tenuously poised, Ehire West won't have long to ponder the relevance of the match as his 50th in black and white before getting down to business. Few of the 2016 woes can be placed at the twinkle-toed feet of the gifted first five, who can and will lead the way to recovery. Yeah. Good feeling in the team that this may be their day. The Stags face equal urgency to win if they're to retain any hope of playoff action. So a comprehensive victory is their ideal result. A lack of consistency and a struggle to finish the 80 minutes as well as they start them are hurdles to overcome. Southland may sense Canterbury have inflicted a blow to the Magpies' morale that can be capitalised on. So an early statement in the form of points is a must. They are plenty. North Harbour and Wellington await the Stags in the coming weeks. We can expect, despite no wins, still full support from the home crowd. And the home team are on the lookout for X-Factor impact, and one with the potential to deliver exactly that is wing Jay Thompson. The natural talent is there for all to see, with game sense that can't be coached. Experience and opportunity with ball in hand can only accelerate the small X to be a capital letter in the near future. And the boy delivering the boy ball tonight, looking every bit the part, is Cody here. He's 9 years old and he hails from the Donovan Primary School. And his favourite Stag is the entire team. So that's generous support from the young man who's enjoyed his moment under the lights. Familiar figure there too. And Glenn Jackson is the referee, Kirk Ray and Aaron Watt on the side. And hopefully Nathan Lyle will be redundant, because the game will flow and all decisions made by the man has just blown the whistle. As Hawke's Bay get the game underway, and Southland will have first possession through their number 8, Mike Murphy, who secured it well for them, and Cowan releases it. And immediately they're looking to run the ball in hand. Here is the man, Jay Thompson, showing gas, and he did breach the defence momentarily. And Southland, a confident start. The box kick from Cowan. more successful. And last week when they played in those horrendous conditions up north, West took it though, unfettered. And now Hawke's Bay, through Brad Webber, loves to scurry, and the damage stopped for the moment by a strong tackle from Collier. But Webber back on his feet to distribute, and he decides not to. Takes it up himself inside the half of the Stags, and that good work is continued by Ben May. Webber again, a long pass to West, he plucks it out of the air. And securing the ball, tackle, looking after it well. And Hawke's Bay backs doing their job in these early stages. Back over the halfway they go. Ball becomes available for Webber, but he gets hustled and bustled by Braden Mitchell, who anticipated well but couldn't dispossess the halfback. Hawke's Bay bringing in fullback. And eventually the mistake is made. It's been a long time coming and a very promising start from both sides, JP.
Oh, absolutely. Confident and enterprising from Southland to start with. Taking it to the width, and maybe just a sign there that I want to kick long and give Hawke's Bay plenty of time with ball in hand. They decided to take it to the width and box kick, try and put them under a wee bit of pressure. And then we saw Hawke's Bay early signs of the danger of a Brad Webber with his sniping. But ultimately pretty well defended by Southland.
This has been a strength of Hawke's Bay. It's Auckland and Canterbury. They put on some very impressive scrummaging. So it'll be a test for the Stags.
Okay, too close. Just keep that gap, boys. Better gap, please.
Kelvin, you'll have a great view of this right in front of you.
Oh, look, it's perfect. I'll tell you, yeah, they have scrummed incredibly well, Hawke's Bay. But by no mean feat, Joe Walsh, Braden Mitchell, Guy Miller up the front of South, and they've held their own for sure.
It'll be an intriguing contest.
Bind! Set!
This time the referee looks happier. And Jimmy Cowan. Scrum under pressure but released plenty of time. And Tua Mavavi showing his strength off the wing. First touch. Cowan's pass is well forward, but already the penalty was in the Stags' favour. And they can well have a lock.
He needs to be checked.
Shot at goal here. We know Harvard is so good from distance.
Okay, just get checked, bro.
I'll tell you what, if Brad Webber hasn't got a slight headache there, I'll tell you what, that was a great hit up there.
Oh, yeah, he's going to check. You're right, Kelvin. And just have a look at this. Tua Mavavi. Boom, Brad Webber. He wore one. He's just, yeah, look, the left of your picture. He stayed down for a wee bit, and referee Glenn Jackson has spotted that. He's asked for him to be checked, so he'll go off for a concussion test.
Yeah, Chris Eaton coming on, jersey 21.
Okay, time on.
Pretty handy replacement, Chris Eaton. A lot of football behind him, and will slot straight into this team.
Last time I was here, Whorunui Haora was kicking them from about 56, 57 metres, so I doubt distance will be an issue with this one.
No, his striking made the highlights package, and deservedly so. Even with the new balls these days, any kicks on your side are halfway that sail over the post and over the dead ball line deserve a replay. You won't mind the angle. First chance at points, Southland Stags. And no mistake off the boot of Harvard. And Southland lead 3-0.
Really accurate start from Southland, right from the kickoff. They've looked assured, they've looked confident, and they've taken some points.
So Jimmy talking 9 to the dozen as he does. Mish Dixon. And first kickoff was deep, with no chance of contest. It's an exact repeat. And Cowan takes it. Decides he won't kick it yet. He'll let the big guys roll it up. And Joe Walsh obliges. Can't kick it out on the full. No intention of doing so. And puts mileage on it. And Eaton will be caught into the fray very early. But he just spins it into the middle. And of course, West, his tactical boot, astute.
Time, heaps of time, Jay.
Finds Thompson. And Harvard eyes his options. The sideline looks a good one. And he finds it. And into the bleachers safely enough.
Keep a close eye on lineouts. Hawke's Bay certainly had some issues with accuracy against Canterbury in their last outing.
Yeah, both teams' lineouts haven't been exactly exceptional. I tell you, Hawke's Bay, they're only running at a 79% success rate. Meanwhile, South on 77, so good challenge for both teams to nail their lineouts tonight. Get their set piece working right from the start.
Nash Dixon, accurate the first throw, and Cridge delivers it in style. And Robbie Fruin, he's always going to be hard to stop. Played very well on this park on numerous occasions, and the transfer excellent. Emerson's got plenty of gas. He beats the first tackler. He shows and keeps the ball. Thought the pass was too risky. Gets to the ground. Eaton quickly there, but he's tackled, so the ball's turned over. And that's a good break for Southland with chases aplenty. But a clever save. Jonah Lowe got back and put his body on the line, but Southland have just driven over the top of it, knowing the law exquisitely, to recover the possession. Jimmy Cowan gets the Stags back line on the counter-attack. Fuka not quite making the 10-metre mark, and no commitment at all from the Magpies. Ball lost in transfer. And Eaton will try and set something up. We prefer to keep it going than to go to the set piece. They've got a bit of a flow on when it comes to back play. Just short of halfway. And West, he knows those gaps. He finds them. He accelerates through. Ehi West, he's got player inside him, but he can't find the support that he needed, and took the tackle instead. That was sensible. Emerson, he's a tough nut to crack. He's determined to look after the ball. He does that well. Riccatelli gets up to the 22. Southland man the barricades. They're under siege at the moment. Fruin. Good, strong tackle from Phil Holder. Put his run to his knees. Scrambling through Falcon. They're getting closer to that 22. Still yet to cross that line. Riccatelli shows the ball. Pops the pass. It's taken by Lowe, but the tackling from Southland was secure. First up. Another example of that. Eaton looks the shorter of the two sides. Good transfer from Dixon, but it only goes as far as Kirk Ray, and holds up the flag to indicate that it's out.
Well, that's twice Emerson's looked dangerous down that left-hand flank, but it was Ehi West who caused the initial problem off this break here. Southland defence had flown up on the outside. He saw the space, and he is so quick. Just waiting now, holding the ball up, looking for support players. But look at the cover defenders from Southland. Three or four jerseys there.
Yes, he kept looking outside. There was a player in, but not very close. Nevertheless, they've come away with the ball. Silly Silly has taken it safely to the 10-metre mark, and Eaton recycles. Abbott. Eaton West. Easy. Oh, back door pass was clever from Falcon. Fruin. Handling slick. That's the day for that. But once again, the defence in numbers from the Stags, and the turnover, a genuine prospect. But the counteract from Hawke's Bay is all equally impressive. In the end, it's resolved for the line-out.
Now, already you can see from down here that Southland's defence has improved immensely. Their line speed, they're really putting a lot of pressure on these guys, especially at the breakdown. They've already got one turnover pull from the breakdown. But again, just look at that, they're competitive. They're really pushing these big boys around.
They get just rewarded when McKee pulls in the line-out ball. Southland, very solid start to their day's outing. This kick from Cowan will be fielded safely enough. Again, the first up tackles are being made, and that's putting pressure on the ball carriers. The double skip pass from West, pushing out to that far left-hand wing. They sense there's something that Falcon can conjure up. A bit isolated for the moment, but Eaton got there quickly. And Ash Dixon buries the head, drives forward, rolls over in places. So Eaton's got clean ball to play with, and he has a little bit of a snipe, but Cowan got in his way. And Southland doing a good job to just make life difficult for Hawke's Bay, but they have conceded a rather handy penalty.
Yes, and the second time down that left-hand flank that Hawke's Bay have broken now. Tian Falcon it was this time. I'm happy to put it into that wide channel. Hawke's Bay, whitish pass to start with, then just flicked on to Falcon. Little bit of a stutter step. Didn't have to do too much, but he's got some good pace. Again, looking for the support players. Tuamavavi, it was, who cut him down after being beaten on the outside. And then we see just here, Junior Nalawafe slapping the ball out of Ash Dixon's hands. And that is penalty time.
West couldn't ask for a handier shot at goal than this. ...73% record. Anything over 70 is acceptable. And missed that opportunity to beat Auckland. He was one of the stars that day and his performance around the park. He welcomed the chance to level the scores. Not going to come around enough, though. And much to the delight of the hometown fans, the score remains 3-0 in Southland's favour.
Just almost looked like he was leaning back a wee bit on that one. High West, just pushing it to the right. Didn't quite get through it.
Brad Weber, he's come back on, guys. He's cleared the concussion test.
Well, that's good news. News for Weber and certainly for Hawke's Bay. Chris Eaton did a very able job in those few moments that the test was taken. Smithson looking to keep distance on the ball and get plenty of it. West centre field looks for space. Didn't find any though. It's well covered by Howard, who puts up an up and under of his own, but he won't like the trajectory. Spins off the boot and into touch. So points victory there to the Bay.
Make sure you're in. Make sure you're
as you can see, crowd building up very nicely for a.
Are you nine? He's nine.
For tonight. Plenty of pies getting sold. S, one,
P, R. Jackson, great view down the line out there. Referee happy that Abbott's delivered. Lamborn and the man himself, Brad Weber on the burst. Brad Weber the try. Give him an inch, he takes a mile.
Oh, what a strike from Hawke's Bay. Perfectly executed set play from the line out. Only really three players involved. Wow, just have a look at this. Back of the line out ball, beautifully taken, popped down to Lamborn. Just wait for him to dart right. He knows Weber's coming. Pops the ball back on the inside, and this guy is just too quick. Brilliant try.
Oh, look, that is exceptional play. Great work, Lamborn. I tell you what, set move all over. Plenty of options, but beautiful popped inside ball. And, yep, he's got wheels. That boy, they won't stop him.
As I mentioned, X factor at the top of the show. Southland needing some, and certainly Hawke's Bay have it in the form of Weber and West to complete the seven-point scoring phase.
Yeah, made it look easy, didn't they? They really did. The ultimate execution.
The initial error, of course, kicking it out and giving Hawke's Bay that opportunity, and then missing a rare tackle so far. Cost Southland 7 points. So I'll put that to one side and move on. They too elect for a non-contestable kickoff. Abbott happy to take it forward and confront the men in maroon. Outside the 22. But it makes no difference. They get the penalty and the opportunity to kick for touch all the
first
same.
First
time he's been killed. So is cool. Matt Phillip had the breakdown. So opportunity to release some pressure again, Hawke's Bay. And the line out started pretty well.
Good distance.
Amazing, isn't it? The wee mistakes that happen. See here, Matt Phillips. He's coming in, killing the ball there, not rolling away from it whatsoever. And look at that, carving off another 50 metres. Good attacking opportunity here, 40 out from the line for Hawke's Bay.
Rolling away might be difficult when someone's holding a jersey.
Yeah, the onus is on the tackle, though. Yep.
Good ball at the back for Cridge. Hands. There's silly a chance to set up a breakdown, but nobody joins in, so Southland players fan out in defence and it works in their favour. They just usher the ball carrier into touch.
continue to pepper that left-hand side. Robbie Fruin this time from the right-hand wing. Well shut down.
Hawke's Bay open. Open.
Discussion amongst the Southland forwards as to the call. Haven't had a lot of ball so far. They'd like to change those numbers around, and this time slightly overthrown, but it falls kindly for them.
Stay on.
Cowan again goes high, and Emerson calls for it and takes it with some skill. And get up and support. And there's a missed tackle again, and the fullback Garland shows real gas. Emerson on the inside, a good scrag tackle saved the day just. Murphy able to slow them down, but there's trouble aplenty for Southland as the numbers in black and white stack up. Lamborn sets it up. Dixon tidies it up. Nicotelli. Another incision by Garland. Jude coming into the line last week. Weber probe, this time unsuccessfully. Boswell Wakefield is the distributor. Cridge rolls into and over the 22 line. West is tempted to have a go himself and then pop the pass. Showing a lot of patience. Weber just looking for any half chance to punch a hole and eventually makes an error.
Gee, they've scrambled. They've recovered well again. Southland under the pump again, left-hand side. And Hawke's Bay just finding all sorts of space down here. It was lovely footwork from Garland to get around narrow space again. Good continuity play to Emerson in a number of phases. And then Weber couldn't quite get the pass away, looking for opportunities, taken in the tackle, and good leg drive in the tackle as well. And that's where he spilled it.
There's a pat on the back for Collier. His persistence.
Bind! Can we just wait for the set? It's twice, we're already set. Both teams just wait for the set.
Seen a lot of promise this season, but not quite delivered, especially not for the 80.
They've had some line breaks already, Tom, haven't they? You know, one try to date, but my word, could have led to a bit more already.
It's West with that first one, warning signs.
Too close, I want the gap here. This side is too close.
Southland will be content with a free kick and an exit of some distance.
One thing about Glenn Jackson, he's very clear on his rulings. Very good communication with the players on the field. So they know in uncertain terms where they stand with him.
A view down the line there as Dixon again finds Abbott with ease. West, pass was very flat but permissible. Lowe got to the ground and the advantage is Hawke's Bay's. Emerson really likes to step on the inside. It's well anticipated on this occasion, but
don't go over the ball. You can't do that.
Consolation prize is a potential shot at goal, at least for position.
Leave the ball alone in the tackle.
Just the importance of the accuracy of that first up hit there. Howard was the man on the tackle.
Shot.
In a good position.
Brandon.
Really positioned well to execute. Let's have a look here. Ball popped off. That's Howard. Not great body position. Turns out a bit buckled over, so he's bumped off. Tack gets him behind, and that just starts problems for Southland.
Well, look, that is Hawke's Bay to a T, and that's probably where they've been lacking this year. They're creating those half breaks, so getting the ball past the player, but they've just been falling at the breakdown. Beyond that, the ball's either getting a bit sloppy or they're getting a bit held up, but we know how good Hawke's Bay are when they're on attack and get that breakdown, get that pass away.
Twice the distance of the first attempt. It's certainly within the range of the High West. From 48 metres. That strike looks promising. He's looking at it for a long, long time. Hits the upright, bounces away, so no extra points. We'll get a bit of extra possession though, because Emerson won't wait for the official line-out, and Robbie Fruin, power aplenty and confidence. There was someone inside, there was, but in between them, Tua Mavavi did a good job in anticipation, snuffed out the threat, and now Southland find themselves some front foot ball, courtesy of Foot. That pass high risk, but came off. Thompson steps well. Cowan. Still Southland. Inch by inch, get closer to that halfway mark. Looking to get into enemy territory and apply some pressure through ball in hand. Tua Mavavi providing that. Made those extra yards, not held. But now the referee decided he was. But there was already an offside infringement. And there'll be no question what Southland will elect to do.
Maybe just sort this out first. Not a lot to
Can't
it, I don't think.
He was tackled, but it's offside.
Yep, but certainly you'll think Southland will have a crack for points. But here's the big fella, Fruin. The danger of the man. He took two defenders. Got the offload away, but Tua Mavavi did well with the intercept. Had an opportunity to the left after that, but then here we see the offsides. Pretty much pick one of four or five there, Hawke's Bay players.
There's the halfway line, making it an easy decision for Glenn Jackson.
Good to see Tua Mavavi back for Southland, playing on the wing. He was injured earlier on in the year. Playing strong too.
Yes, it was a nasty hand injury. They thought might put him out for the season. He's come back, and it's good to see, because he was in great form in club football.
Well, given what we've seen to date, if Southland can nudge this one over, 1 point behind at this stage, I think they'd be relatively happy.
And he just doesn't seem to get any kicks close to the goal, does he? They're all a mile away, but he takes them in his stride and slots the goal. A magnificent display once more of the kicking team. Brings the teams together by that single point.
Yeah, he's hitting them sweetly, he really is. Doesn't seem to be any doubt in his mind. He just slots it, turns around, heads back.
It's just a two-step run-up too. It's amazing. It's all timing, isn't it? All timing.
Yeah, I read an article after the match referred to a couple of weeks ago where he was kicking them for 56-57, and he said he'd actually surprised himself with a couple of those.
What confidence he would have got from those long-range kicks early in the season, and it's just continued on from there. West with a shorter kick this time. Still not the key able to secure it and have the troops rally around him. Cowan has a glance of it around his left shoulder, but continues to spur on the men in front of him. And once again, he's got even more height on this kick, and Emerson, not so secure, goes to the side. But the referee decides there was enough forward impetus to call it a knock-on. Net result, scrum in Southland's favour.
They're using Jimmy Cowan a lot for those, aren't they, Calvin? And this time it's worked perfectly. That's what they're after. Not contestable, but enough height and enough pressure, and sooner or later, that's the sort of thing that comes about.
Yeah, I must admit, the first one that Jimmy did straight from the kickoff, I thought, well, I'll tell you what, he's probably put a couple of thousand or so of them up at this field.
Crouch!
Centurion, Southland.
Bind!
Great player, look at him. Always got the banter.
Just never short of a word.
Stay on.
It'll never change. Cowan's pass. Not the best, but pulled down nicely. Tua Mavavi really coming into his own in terms of work rate, looking for things to do and doing them well. Can't say the same of that outside back move, which through a little confusion came to an abrupt halt.
Well, clearly missing communication in the width, the wide pass towards the end, but brilliant carry from Tua Mavavi. Just have a look here, Howard, I wasn't expecting a runner off his shoulder, but Tua Mavavi had to collect a high pass to start with, and then he peaked. Well, beat one and carried another defender, made 5 or 10 metres. Excellent carry.
Tell you what, see a fair amount of strapping on Robbie Fruin's right leg there. She's a big leg itself, takes a full roll of tape. But I tell you what, he's feeling it.
Set.
Just had a bad run with injuries over the years, and And such great power and speed and finesse when he's fully fit, as does this man when it comes to speed, as Weber and away, and the cover tackle, Jim McCown's specialty. To take the player into touch, who claims it was a little high, and the referee has agreed.
That's the competitiveness of Cowan, though, isn't it? He was just desperate to make that tackle. Weber got away down that short right-hand side. He was not going to let them get too far.
There's one thing about Weber. Boy, oh boy, he is fast, isn't he? And he unleashes, obviously, an All Black, Montest All Black.
And that first 20 metres, isn't it? He just makes the break and he's got good pace thereafter. Got to watch him every step of the way. 26 minutes gone and just 1 point. Speculation this would be quite a high scoring game given how beautiful day it was. Over the short side, doesn't make a lot of progress. Try again through Ben May, two props combining on that occasion. Abbott low and straight to Dick. Dixon adding his might to the push, but has to whip round the back and help out again. Southland's defence, an occasional breach, has been solid overall. And now going to be tested tackle again. Ben May within six.
Leave it, tackler.
And another surge. Ball's available. This time, the lock. Abbott can get no further. Weber to Dixon, and Dixon within three. Weber again, probing from near and afar. Oh, two men under the tackler. Under the tackle should keep it safe for Southland, and does, but for the moment. Hang on again, Southland.
Hey, leave it.
A little frustration here from Hawke's Bay.
Jimmy,
out. Big man on me, man.
You could normally say it. Yeah, there we go.
Webber's not annoying people by any chance, is he?
A scrum, he couldn't roll, in my opinion.
Jimmy did that well. Got out of there before he got in trouble.
Some fire in those eyes.
Anyway, Hawke's Bay, hot on attack. They were looking dangerous.
You build up a good repertoire, don't you, Kelvin, after 250 first-class games? You must have all the patter.
Oh, I'll tell you what, he could write a book about it. Yeah, great attacking opportunity here for Hawke's Bay.
Well, 8-9. There's danger looming.
Movement. Say it again.
Some big boys in that Hawke's Bay back line just lining up. You can see them.
Yeah, one in particular.
Yeah. I'll tell you what.
Yeah, they will come straight off 9, Robbie Fruin. Could be 8-9 Fruin.
Isn't that great to have that man of that size in your back line? Either use him as a battering ram or flip the ball behind him. You can see there, Falcon.
Towers over West.
Use it now, 9.
Will they use them? That'll be the million-dollar question. No, Weber wants to go himself, and he's a little bit isolated for just a moment, but there's still numbers of black and white players. Cowan tries to kick the ball through. That's a technique. A lot of teams are using a breakdown. Couldn't get his boot to the ball. And this time, Southland again have prevailed on defence.
Oh, they've done well to hold out here, Southland. As it turns out, they tried to use Fruin as a decoy. Weber thought he might catch Jimmy Cowan out on the left-hand side. But the experience was there. They've done extremely well to hold out. Dangerous Weber this close to the line. He's so quick from the base. Tried a little footwork, but Cowan was the man to the task. Dropped him there. Hawke's Bay looking for the pick and go. And Riccitelli it is. And it ultimately went to Dick.
More quality ball delivered. Southland pick up another penalty. And 2 minutes ago, defending manfully their goal line, and now find themselves on attack as a result of this kick.
Mark Abbott, guilty one there, coming across the line, getting an offside position, but I'll be quite happy to get down this part of the field. Well, Southland been under the pump in their own half.
Keep the discipline, eh?
Yeah, Mark Abbott just creeping in from the side. Tried to get out, but too late.
Well, trying to get in before it formed, was he?
Ball is made, ball is delivered, both from the hooker and off the top. Now it is passed to Moffat, well read by the defence. Hawke's Bay now called upon to make some tackles in doing so. Southland's path narrow down that channel. Polly are able to retain the ball quickly on Phillip, who's Hawke's Bay defensive line, but oh, the gap just half open, the ball lost in the transfer. And now Hawke's Bay fighting manfully to keep it. And that was power from Lambourne. Weber, he's just
not held.
Picks up just 3 or 4 metres and suddenly everything's on the front foot. West, the passing behind. Staying on their feet, but not for long. Hawke's Bay with an advantage, and it's a penalty one. Southland players again trapped, not rolling away.
Hey, boys.
He's Tuamavavi, it was this time, I think, conscious. Actually being broken down that left-hand side 2 or 3 times earlier on. He just does not want to let that happen again. So perhaps trying to flow or stem the flow of that momentum of Hawke's Bay a little bit as well.
They've opted for the line, Kelvin. I think they'll be thinking they had a lot of ball here, and 1 point's not enough advantage.
Yeah, I think so. And again, we talk about that back line. You got Fruin in it, Falcon, Jonah Lowe. Yeah, some big boys there. Just see here the guilty party there, Tuamavavi, not rolling away from the ball. But here's another great attacking chance. I'll be looking forward to hold on to the ball this time, Hawke's Bay.
Over.
Off the back this time, and Emerson off his wing. Solid tackle by Howard. The wave of black and white jerseys continues to flow over. Cridge, Webber, Ben May is confronted. The defence manfully. Cridge again. All the big men doing their part, trying to take the ball forward. West away to Falcon, and transfer to Fruin came eventually, but by then 3 tacklers were upon him. Weber's fast pass, it's really provided a half chance for it, and he's back clearing again. Another probe by Garland. Southland again in the face of Hawke's Bay, and again they managed to salvage something out of it.
Yeah, they continue to hold, Kelvin. That's a good effort from Southland. The Hawke's Bay are throwing everything at them. Great line, this. He's coming back on the angle. Boswell Wakefield looked like he might create enough. And Southland are just back on their feet, realigning, keep coming forward. Just managed to get a hand in there, and they hold on again.
It's cast our minds back to this time last year in the Hawke's Bay Southland match. Ryan Tongio, who we may see later on, had a field day, a couple of tries. He starts this one and finishes it. Wasn't a brilliant weather, but the handling was. And look at the number 14 as he loops around and then inside and finishes it off to enable Hawke's Bay to complete their victory, which was by 35 to 28 in the end.
Look, I think that piece of play there, that just... it's a great example of what Hawke's Bay are not doing tonight. Southland are a part guilty too. They're just not holding on to their ball good enough. Look, conditions down here are good. There's a slight dew, but definitely not enough wetness for that ball to be slipping around in the tackle. I think they just have a wee... both teams need to have a wee bit of patience. And look at that. Southland only be down by 1 point. Hawke's Bay, 74% possession. That's incredible.
Mason Emerson back to his feet, and the scrum
set
in the shadow of the goalposts. This will be a test of that Stags pack, and so far they've passed it. Gave Murphy enough time to get off the back and scurry away. And that's the time and space that Cowan needed to send the ball back into Hawke's Bay half, and Emerson tricked by the bounce. And this time Garland kicks to get a lot of territory. Now Olafi, he likes space to work in and got some on a plate. And Cowan with a run, inside pass. Collier, good understanding between Now Olafi and Moffat. Here's Thompson, right on the edge of the outside line. Somehow the ball's stayed in the field of play and halted it well to ensure Southland retain. Good constructive play by Southland. Hawke's Bay have sneaked around offside, so a penalty in their favour. They can be more adventurous, like those pop passes. It'll go astray, but will be brought back to a kickable position. And the lead is a possibility for the Stags with five to go.
Offside.
Oh, could be passage from Southland. It was attacking down the left-hand side, really desperate to keep the ball alive. Maybe took a couple of risks, but they paid off. And a lovely wee break from Harwater that nearly opened it up. And we see Cowan, so a direct approach this time, offload on the inside. The ball's popped away again, loose-ish passes. Well, they do well just to keep the ball alive here. Jay Thompson looked like he was going out, somehow managed to keep it in. So they recover, go again. Little untidy around the breakdown. It's causing them some problems. At Hawke's Bay certainly getting stuck in there. And that's where the penalty came. Adjudged to have been offside. But gee, they haven't had too many chances to attack, have Southland. In fact, I think they've made 60-odd tackles in this first half compared to Hawke's Bay. It would be probably a quarter of that at most.
Record. Our stats people tell us Southland have spent just 11 seconds inside the 22 of Hawke's Bay. So they'll take every point offered, and they do, both hands. Southland hit the lead 9-7. Doesn't matter how they come, they're coming thick and fast at the moment for Southland off the boot.
No, if you look at the stats, you wouldn't pick the score. Southland defensively tonight have been outstanding today.
It's energy sapping stuff, the defence, but when you look up and you're in the lead, somehow you find that extra bit of zest. And that turnover, perhaps a little bit soft on that occasion, but Dixon's under pressure from Holder. Hawke's Bay may not have control of this, and they do eventually to scramble.
Leave it now, leave it.
Now it's presented at last. Cridge confronted. The penalty coming this time for Hawke's Bay. That lead may be short-lived for Southland, but Weber doesn't want the shot at goal. He wants to keep running. He gets another strike to the head. He's taking a bit of punishment today as the nine. Here's Cridge running at will, but it ended up a complete mess, and the penalty in front of the post will be the preferred option for Magpies.
Card time, which is trouble. And I think that might be for Mika Murphy, Southland number 8. So that's going to put him under further pressure. Pretty smart from Brad Weber, instinctive for him.
Shot.
Tap and go, but it bought them another 10 metres and makes this attempt that much easier. So solid defence again. This is the not 10. Well, that's where it's come from. Mika Murphy, a little bit high as it turns out as well. That's probably because Weber just ducked. Not particularly high to start with, to be honest, but...
Yeah, the instinct, though, is not to let Weber run, isn't it? I think that's what came to the mind of the number 8.
Yeah, of course.
So with 70% of the ball, they do not want to get into the halftime break with without some kind of lead. It'll be a slim one if this is successful. Beautifully straight this time, and indeed the Bay get their lead back in the final throws of this first half. Robbie Fruin has looked threatening without having a hand in a try just yet. A lot of intensity and heavy breathing going on. It's been a game of good pace, good movement, and despite the low score, enjoyable for the crowd that have turned up in good numbers. Southland will be very keen to make sure there's no further damage to the scoreline. West happy that will continue to spin it wide, and here is Fruin, and he does get through the tackle. He gets the pass on the inside, and it's well picked up. Beautiful hands by Garland. He's under pressure from a tackler immediately, but they've recycled the ball. Rigatelli is thumped to the ground. It's a huge tackle, and now there's trouble. There's a bit of pushing and shoving, but Emerson gets back there, and there's a bit of booing from the crowd because they thought a Southland player chasing through may have been impeded. The referee puts his whistle to his mouth, and I think he's awarded for that very offence.
What number?
And there's a call for a card, I believe. Whether it'll go that far,
what number?
We'll have to wait and see.
Do you know the number?
No, I haven't got the number.
Okay, we'll just time off.
Well, it's Jay Thompson, the man that was held.
I just want to know what number held back, please.
But the hold E, I'm not too sure of.
I was happy there was enough cover. I just wanted to know the number, please.
So he doesn't think it's a severe offence because there were other players available, so no penalty try option.
Oh, Levi West, yeah.
That's a penalty.
Just enough. I don't think it made much difference, really, but...
Look worse in real time. It's whether he deems it enough to level the numbers in terms of players
10.
On the field, okay, and he's going
10.
To. So, key playmaker.
Pulling back.
Levi West will spend the first 10 minutes of the second half watching.
Yeah, I mean, given what goes on in the footy field, it's tough.
Time on.
I think when you've given a card out previously for a cynical foul,
you set the
pace. No complaints from the Stags.
Thanks, Aaron.
Great read here, Bill Fuka-Fuka. What a tackle on Riccatelli. That was danger time. And we smacked him, and there's the wee infringement. Just held him a little. Don't think it meant that it prevented Thompson from getting to the ball first. However, he could have made the tackle once he got there.
Yes, that's the instinct that Thompson has that I mentioned earlier. Just a natural for knowing where the ball's going to be. Be effective when he gets there. Talking about effective, how good is this man when it comes to lining up the goals? Keeping Southland in the game. The prospect of a head. Last act, first half. A successful penalty kick at goal, with Southland now in the lead by 12 points to 10 over Hawke's Bay. Under all sorts of pressure, they've withstood it, and they now take that 2-point lead into the changing rooms. As Kelvin prepares himself for having a chat with the winger for Hawke's Bay, Mason Emerson.
Yeah, well, Mason, you've had 75% of the possession, but just struggling with that continuity.
Yeah, I think so, and I think that's the main thing we've been working on in recent weeks, hey, just kind of keep that ball. Because with those new rules, you know, if you keep it, it's pretty hard to turn it over, unless you're making some mistakes. And
you'll be happy with conditions. They're pretty good down here, aren't they?
Yeah, it's perfect compared to last year when I think there was 150k winds. It's a lot better, eh? Better to play in and good for some running rugby, which both teams are pretty keen to do.
Hey, look, all the best for the second half.
Cheers.
Well, Jonah Lowe described Mason Emerson as tougher than a woodpecker's lips. His team trails by 2 points. Southland 12, Hawke's Bay 10. smiling faces of the Southland Girls High School rugby team. They're doing a victory lap around the field on the back of Utes after winning the New Zealand Secondary School Girls Rugby title, beating St Mary's College in the final 46-29, a successful season undefeated after 13 games in 2016. So here are the highlights of the match. Stags themselves may be doing a victory lap because Harwood is keeping them in the game with his boot. And then this try from Hawke's Bay turned the game in their favour. Watch out for the number 9. That's the golden rule on the inside. Brad Weber away. And unstoppable with that speed, JP.
Oh, absolutely. Set play here. Lambour did it beautifully as well. That pass turned to the inside to this guy with all the wheels in the world.
And yes, we enjoyed a few weeks ago, Hara from everywhere in the field. Distance, close up. Mandis does not miss. Great rhythm. Great composure under pressure as he put his team in front. A couple of yellow cards has changed the course of the game. Murphy out of Southland's action with a couple of minutes to go before the end. And then this tug of the jersey by Ehiah West also sent him to the sin bin. He's got a full 10 to serve on the sideline. But the stats, JP, I'm sure they will tell you in a moment, quite a different story to their scoreline. But we see at the moment, of course, Weber scoring the only try. But Southland hit the lead by a couple.
Well, 12 points to 10, but just have a look at this stats board. You would not believe it. Position, time and opposition half. And look at that, time and opposition 22. Over 4 minutes for Hawke's Bay. Only come up with the one try to date. Southland 18 seconds and Hawke's Bay's 22. Tackles made 74-21. Somehow they've managed to hold on.
Of course, the only numbers that matter are those on the scoreboard, and these guys will be reflecting on their hard work on defence, which has had good reward. They've got themselves into positions where they can slot a couple of goals. That's been delivered, and there'll be frustration for the Magpies as they find themselves down by a couple. When we return to Rugby Park Stadium, it'll still be Southland 12, Hawke's Bay 10. Huge defensive effort by Southland. The coach is going to be proud of that. Hawani McDonald with Kelvin.
Yeah, Hawani, 18 seconds in Hawke's Bay, 22. That's all you've had to be up. 12 to 10, you'll be happy.
Yeah, it was pretty average half footy for us. So to be up at half time, we're happy with that. But we just need up our energy, yeah.
Yeah, defence has taken its toll. You've had 74 tackles, though, but you'll be looking forward to getting your hands on the pill and attacking.
Yeah, like we've been scrambling really well, so but boys have made a lot of tackles, and so hopefully they can just keep making those tackles and probably start playing a bit of footy down their end.
Hey, look, all the best. We'll see, Marv.
So just reminding you that Southland minus one player for about another 8 or so minutes. That's Murphy, the number 8, and Hawke's Bay will have 14 players for 10 minutes as Ehiah West serves out his punishment. So 14 on 14 in this opening stanza of the second half.
Interesting to see who Hawke's Bay slot into 10. First receiver controlling the game.
Yep. Southland will get the restart. Hawke's Bay the first possession. And as JP says, will be the playmaker in behind when they recycle this ball. And Weber contend on forwards taking it in the box kick as the follow-up. Taken nice with Thompson, and the high kick from Noah Luffy. Hanging in midnight air, the late night air. Tua Mavavi comes away with it. Referee happy that that exchange resulted in no knock-ons. Straight into the arms of Hawke's Bay. He can return that with interest. And a scurry back, but oh, Hardy keeps it in very cleverly. No, he doesn't. And the touch judge confident, or the AR, I should say, that a foot crossed the line.
Oh, that's a brilliant kick from Jonah Lowe. He's Just have a look here, Haora. Oh, he did just touch the tape, I think. But Jonah Lowe, he banana kicked that off the right foot, positioned it perfectly, and with the banana angle, it bounced towards that touchline. Brilliantly placed.
That stat tells you that the halftime lead has been in Southland's favour before, not always resulted in a win at the end. We've got some more tackling to be done. Five out, it's rolling more, looks promising for Hawke's Bay as they get closer and closer. It's well tucked in behind. Over, try. No doubt whatsoever, Hawke's Bay have started their second half with a try. Ash Dixon, the scorer. Oh, or is it?
I think it is. Let's have another wee look. I thought it was Ash Dixon. We'll have another wee look, but what a change. Hammered away and hammered away for 40 minutes in the first half. Hawke's Bay can only come up with the one try. 2 minutes into the second half, boom. Let's have a wee look. Set play from the line out. See Dixon joining the back of it. Well controlled, pretty straight drive. Started to splinter, kept it under control. Dixon's on the ball now. And yeah, he works it there, and it is Ash Dixon, the try scorer.
And you've got a player missing. All points are cherished. And therefore, a new goal kicker, Tian Falcon. There's a long heritage, family heritage playing for Hawke's Bay. Not successful on this occasion. We'll take the 5 points though. Ash Dixon. He'll be happy with that start.
Oh, that Southland defence had been immaculate in the first half, certainly in their own territory. One little error led to this line out, and it was superbly executed by Hawke's Bay.
Dream start for the forwards, Kelvin.
Oh, incredible, isn't it? Looks to be no changes down here at half time, I suppose, with a man each in the bin. Keep it nice and settled.
And taken nicely by Thompson, good ball skills. Noah Luffy goes centre field.
Inside. And
very much obvious that Falcon is taking out that tactical kicking role. Finds Noah Luffy. Returns to the same player, is it? No, this is Lowe coming across now. And he puts the ball on the far side. Bounces into touch safely enough in Southland's territory.
With TM Falcon, indeed, he's played a lot at first five, especially for club football. So you talk about his heritage, Dan Gordon, 74 games. Hawke's Bay, his granddad Ray, both Māori All Blacks. A good heritage in that boy.
Tell you what, I remember both of them. When you remember players' granddads, you've been watching a lot of football. Although that was, I think, in the 80s, so it's not that long ago, I don't think so. But anyway, a new era in the making. Good exchange, Boswell Wakefield got this pass away before he hit the ground and then able to clean out, helping Riccatelli. Got hands from Garland. Acceleration from Lowe, inside pass to Garland. He's going to finish the job off in style as the fullback. That's a wonderful try to watch.
Oh, bang, bang for Hawke's Bay, two in a row within the space of minutes. They have certainly found some space on the fringes of the Southland defence. And some brilliant running again from Jonah Lowe that has created this small space down the right-hand channel. This is Lowe with the hands to start with, or rather into Lowe's hands. And look at that for an offload. That's a 10-metre offload, threaded between two players into Matt Garland's hands, and he's a try scorer.
Oh, look, how do you teach that, JP? I'm sure if anyone knew could, but tell you what, that is just skill, and that is something that Hawke's Bay can do. Extremely skillful, extremely fast.
Yeah, who needs 15 players? Quite nicely. With just the 14. I suggest two more points added to the tally. 22-12. Deficit well and truly wiped out.
quick change here for Southern. Loose head, Joe Walsh coming off, and the ball running ability man, Penny Uravai, coming on, jersey 17 for Southland.
Yes, he's been very effective, hasn't he, Ravai? And he's just the sort of impact player they need to get going forward again. If they can get their hands on the ball, Hawke's Bay denying them for every second of this second half, looking after the ball well. Partly charged, could go anywhere, it does. Tidied up by Riccatelli. Prepared to put his body between ball and the opposition. Thompson calls for it, bobbled for a moment, found Nailafi. Hawara. And Tuamavavi, who looked the most dangerous of the runners of Southland's back in the first half. Cowan is confronted, but got the pass away. Now, Miller getting ball through, but the first pop-up pass went to Black and White. Webber. Dixon. Dixon presents. Webber distributes. And they go. Ben May. Front row are so mobile these days. Doing such a big part. Webber ducks and dives. And nips under two tackles. He's hard to stop. That's in every fine. Respect. Emerson thinks he can barge his way through. He's wrong, because Murphy's back for Southland. And they now have 15. Oh, high-risk pass that was intercepted. And here's a chance for Southland on the counter.
Knock on. But
knock on.
Offside.
And then
down.
An offside. So the net result for Southland
offside.
Isn't bad at all.
Oh, the injury could be, though. Collier, they can afford that.
There's a breakdown, not
it looks like he might be all right. It was danger time again for Southland. Hawke's Bay starting to link their passes very dangerously. Ball in behind here. They know there's opportunity on the outside, so the wide pass comes. Read very well by Collier and gets the pass away. And then another pop pass here, which Lowe had read and stopped to try and cut off the passing lane. But in doing so, offside.
It's good play, Kelvin, by Riccatelli. He knew that he wasn't going to get the ball, so he just concentrated on the tackle. Could have been a lot worse than a shot at goal. ...92% is quite good for a kicker, JP. You'd be happy with that?
You'd be extremely happy with that, yeah. There'd be too many end up in the 90s at the end of a season.
Especially when most of them have been 40 plus metres away. It looks sweet. And yet again, that record. Night perfect.
And keeps them in touch, Southland. Three tries to none. They stay in touch. We'll live another day.
Ehi West coming back on after his time in the naughty chair.
Is that 14-3 point?
Well, they didn't miss him, did they?
Don't tell him that. Yeah, restart. Taken by West. To type by putting it deep inside the 22 and getting out quickly on defence, and Murphy showing good power. Southland prepared to run from depth.
Tackle. Inside.
Now they'll use the boot. They can kick it out on the full. And do so.
Well, they used that tactic in the first half. It was actually from the first kickoff of the match, where they took it to the width and used Cowan's box kick with a wake of pressure. This time they've kicked into touch, so ball away well inside their own territory. Hawke's Bay throw the line out.
Front here.
Line out so far.
Front runner. You see there, Hawke's Bay use a lot of attacking ball off the tail of the line out.
Contested, but still won by Hawke's Bay, keeping that perfect record intact. And Fruin up strongly. So to Abbott. plenty of volunteers to keep that ball going forward for Hawke's Bay. Cridge among them, twisting, turning, and now well inside the danger zone. A bit isolated there for Riccatelli, but ball presented so quickly. Froome got it away in the tackle marvellously, but the referee decided it was forward. It would have only been marginally so.
It's forward on the line.
Oh, and I think he's claiming that it came backwards out of his hands. We might have another wee look, but either way, just have a look at the lifted intensity, the speed that Hawke's Bay are doing things at now. The carries, the cleans. Nothing's going to get away with that one. That is forward, but just the running onto the ball now because of the speed of the ruck outside. From the quality of the clean and the carry to start with is really lifted for Hawke's Bay.
Yeah, look, I'll tell you what's happening to Southland too. They're bringing on a few on the bench here. Kieran Moffat coming off. James Schrader, jersey 22 going on. So, yeah, that tackling rate is taking its toll on the Southland boys, and they have got a big workload coming up with four games in 15 days. So,
what's happening?
Plenty of rugby for the boys.
I want a bind, not
yes,
the strikes,
okay? Intense program in front of them.
Let's get your bind up and we'll see.
Captain Mitchell. Enjoying the role as leader of the team. Obviously would like some more success, but he knew it was a work in progress. New squad, lots of young potential talent. And it's a very tough competition. And Weber and Cowan have a right royal battle today. Now Luffy gets a lot of distance on his kick and it's fumbled by Garland. The referee decides, yes, two is a forward, is a knock-on. So Southland on attack.
Well, I think that's a good exit strategy from Southland too, kicking from the width when that defence has already come up. And it just wobbled around a wee bit. Poor Matt Garland. Yeah, they got an awkward position before he put that one down. But rather than going to the ruck at the width, Hawke's Bay then able to put pressure on the clearance. They just kicked straight from hand once that defence was up. Plenty of space in behind. Good strategy.
Yeah, again, a pretty much non-existent wind down here. Conditions again, as they were at the start of the game, just perfect. Ground, just exceptional.
Southland will give thought to that Herculean effort against Manawa 2 with the game looked lost. Themselves well and truly back into it, only to have it snatched from the last moment. But it was a fantastic comeback. Shows that they've got it in them.
We'll use to Mavavi a lot from the scrum line out. You can see him just hanging at the back of the behind Harbour.
Bind! Sit!
Good solid platform for Cowan to work off. Happy this to flick the ball on. Just pass went in behind Nawalafi that slowed him down, but then he accelerated off the mark and beat three players. Easy. But, Silly did very well getting back and got plenty of boot on it.
Play on.
So they'll have to start again through Thompson.
Play on.
And then Collier. His head down and the accelerator. Thompson again, staying handy to the action. Cowan. And good period of possession. Nawalafi with the inside pass. Collier in support. Pops the pass around the outside to Nawalafi, who stayed close. Now the crowd are getting into the game because Murphy saw the try line just 10 metres ahead.
Leader now!
Southland still through Murphy having another poke. Five out. Hawke's Bay needing to replicate the defence that Southland put on early in the match to keep their line intact. Short side, very narrow. Just a knock on in that transfer sport was such a promising move.
Oh, excellent attack from South, and it was the continuity. Superb. All started with a Nalawafu break from broken play. With beautiful footwork. This time he's involved in a pass inside the Collier. There's the continuity. Nalawafu again. Mika Mafi with his power. They get there in numbers, but then at the crucial stage, again, just a little miscommunication. And I think we could hear the frustration soon after.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, this game is taking its toll on a few. Brad Webber, he was right in it from the start, wasn't he, Tom?
Yep, JP, I'm sure you enjoy this more than most.
Yeah, well, we've seen it before, haven't we? See it time and time again, how electrifying this guy is on the break. Just out and out speed, and he certainly has a nose for it. He just needs no space at all. Can create absolute havoc for opposition defences. Smaller stature, quick mover, not only with his speed, but just generally in everything he does. And yeah, he's a real danger man. He's a handful.
That's why rugby is such a fantastic game. It's a game for all sizes. And he's quite diminutive. Boy, when you've got gas and courage as he has, you can make your mark and have a great success in the sport. Two very good halfbacks of completely different dimensions who've carved out good careers.
Bind! Set.
Brown still issuing some advice. But that solid pack of Hawke's Bay are now finding themselves having to use the backs to grind their way out of trouble. And Bruin presented the ball eventually, and West was happy that he had some time. Now Luffy's got more into this game as it's gone on, the confidence in his running growing ever so. And then just accidentally kicked away, but falls kindly for Fukufuka. And suddenly the passes are sticking for Southland that weren't before. Advantage for Southland in a very handy spot. So one more burst from Tuamavavi. Jimmy Cowan within five. Looking likely is Southland. Still got that penalty advantage.
Advantage over!
Until now. So they really do need to score. And the big boy Rabbi can't make a lot of progress.
Stay on, stay on.
I don't know how Cowan can probe at the fringes. Fukufuka taken front on. And Ash Dixon's in there, trying to wrestle it free, can't. Another push from Miller. Jimmy's getting the call, left, right and centre. He goes left. Rabbi can't make it, but gets ever so close. And very quick pass. Holder, though. A good demonstration of goal line defence from both teams this evening. A surge from Southland. They've got another penalty in their favour. Tide just turning in. And the try scored. And it is Rabbi who comes up with the points eventually after all that hard work.
Oh, the explosive Penny Rabbi. This guy can go, played sevens and quite a bit of it. And he loves to run with ball in hand. He's a man that ultimately finished, which was some outstanding attack from South and certainly growing in confidence. The offloads are sticking, attacking the line now. This was Hara, popped that ball beautifully into space for Tuamavavi. Cowan on the inside, the continuity. And previously it's broken down, but it's really good patience here from Southland. One off attack. Took their time, regathered, but then Ravi's plucked it from the base, almost unopposed. He's explosive.
Three-quarter mark of this game. The hour nearly up. And Southland face the prospect of levering the points. And this record continues to impress all. And it's not an easy kick from the side of the field. Style, poise and shape the same as ever before with the same result. And now we have a game on our hands, 22 all, 20 to go.
8-9. Oh yeah, game on. Southland forced to defend so much in that first half. Finally, have got some opportunity to attack. Some fresh legs and their confidence has grown.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, Hawke's Bay ringing in the changes too. Riccatelli coming off. Fava Mokioa going on, jersey 18. Also Brad Webber coming off and Chris Eaton coming back on, jersey 21.
Stretching the head, Hawke's Bay. every time they look to take control of this match, it's taken away from them. They get another chance. They just get a sense that through Tua Mavavi, now Luffy and a couple of the runners, they sense they've got the Hawke's Bay on the back foot. And those kicks are just falling nicely for them as well.
Yeah, back to Cowan again. That's a great clearance, it really is. Anything beyond the 40 metre with an angle like that, that's an excellent effort.
Interesting to see how Hawke's Bay, this is their third game, 8 days. And we talked about Southland. This is their first game coming up, and out of 4 and 15. So, yeah, hectic schedule. Going to be interesting for the last quarter of the game. See how both teams fare.
Two.
Yeah, that schedule not so daunting if you've got a win under your belt to start it. There's some work to be done by both teams now. Eaton had that brief appearance early in the game to cover for a concussion test and made his presence felt. Rahimokio has done the same with his first touch. Enabled this movement to keep forward. He's in the action again as the big prop. And gets the ball away in the tackle. The step from Falcon. Tackle secure from Muffy. Now 10 out from the 22. Eaton distributes. Ben May. Eaton again. Cridge has a lot of touches. And he's made good ground when he's been able to stretch those long legs. And Ash Dixon just powers his way forward to the 22. Eaton has to scramble on the ground and he's good under pressure. West slipped the pass away to Emerson in a tackle. So everything done. The tackle is on them and here comes Robbie Fruin and his inside pass. Well, intercepted. But it has been lost forward. It'll only be a scrum, but Hawke's Bay will be happy with the position of it.
Well, happy with that, yes, but if that pass had gone to hand, that was try time. Yep. Robbie Fruin.
9-10-14.
He's exploded into that space. String it together well again from the left-hand width here. Ash Dixon, a little bit of urgency. And then just look at that, just took off. If that pass had gone to hand, I suspect it was big trouble for Southland.
Yeah, there we go, Jimmy Cowan coming off, and indeed. All interest watching on jersey 21, Michael Dowsett, 24-year-old. Playing a fair bit of Brumbies, 22 games for the Brumbies. Also going on, Josh Clark, Phil Helder coming off. Josh Clark, jersey 20.
Yeah, busy afternoon for Phil Helder. I thought he was very effective. So I don't know how Robbie Fruin missed the two players. One behind one and in front of the other. New halfback drafted in.
Crouch!
Bit of an Australian contingent. Yeah.
Good super experience under his belt, that'll help. Eaton. Not required initially. Now it's coming off the scrum, I think. Could send Hawke's Bay to the kicking tee if they don't make something of this. Yes, it was an offside call. And Dixon knows the weight of the turf for security purposes. West kick out wide, brilliantly taken by Emerson, brilliantly finished by the left winger. Skills are plenty.
Oh, that is some skill. That really is. The kick pass, absolutely brilliant. I'm not sure if that was pre-called or they just saw the space. There was plenty of it. But you have to execute well, and you don't execute any better than this. Ehire West knows the space is there, knows that the attacking player is there. And really, once he'd gathered it, Mason Emerson, a little bit to do, sure. Well, that's a brilliant try and a brilliant show of skill execution. Pretty good catch, to be fair.
Mooted celebrations. Again, they push themselves into bonus point territory. One each at the moment. Kicking record of West not quite as impressive as his opposite. to just slightly improve those percentages over 500 points for Hawke's Bay. Under his belt. And another couple to add to his tally and the team's. The lead now 7.
Okay. More changes are plenty for Southland. Mike McKee coming off. And we've got Michael Stewart, jersey 19, going on. Also, Tua Mavavi, strong game, jersey 14. He's six. Coming off for Southland. Coming on in 25, Mike Malloy.
Hawke's Bay just finding something to keep their noses in front. But Southland have come back every single time so far. Can they do so once more?
Backwards.
Bobbled, backwards. Knocked backwards into the arms of Cridge. And he's rolled forward.
Stay in front. Roll
to West.
On now.
And he sends it 50 metres downfield. Howard took it. And Thompson is gifted off the boot as he is with ball in hand.
Backwards.
Good height. And it's forward in for Fahamokio. Forward pass off him in Southland's favour. Comedy of errors and not very funny at that.
That was all over the show, wasn't it? Jay Thompson gathered the kick himself. Well, half gathered it, knocked it back. But he had no support players with him. And Fahamokio it is. Yeah, he's just man in the right
slippery,
spot, wasn't he? This
slippery
one comes off his head.
That was a falcon.
You'll see it. Glancing blow.
Look, I talk about this Mitre 10 Cup and the developing, all these young kids coming out, the likes of Mason Emerson, all these great future stars. But we've got Ross Filippo, the young 37-year-old coming on, jersey 19, Hawke's Bay.
Yes, indeed. Good to see him still in the game, making a contribution.
Stay on.
Southland. After that mad scramble, still ended up with the ball. Let's see what they can do by spinning it. That's the best presentation for Mike Malloy for his first incision into the game, but he tidied it up quite usefully.
Backwards.
Pass was hard, towed through, could go anywhere, but Thompson finds the touchline and the safety thereof.
Untidy there. Southland really trying to shovel it while forced to shovel it. Was he keen to keep it in hand, but they did so under pressure, going right then left. Passes to ground and put themselves under pressure.
Yeah, both teams just trying to be wee bit hard. Lost some of their structure. Again, Southland were good earlier on, as were Hawke's Bay, was just holding on to the ball. Bit of patience.
Crossover game, of course. Hawke's Bay Premiership, Southland Championship. And the drive by Hawke's Bay gets them ever so close with a penalty advantage in their pocket.
Collapsing.
They may just have a little probe at the touchline, I suggest, JP.
Wouldn't be surprised, Tom. Very effective from this spot. Beginning of the second half, and they'll back themselves here, I would think.
Stop them! 10
out. Shows Kelvin how tough that
boys,
premiership
discipline.
Competition is. Once you get out of it, Wellington haven't bounced straight back. Hawke's Bay are in there, having to struggle for every point.
Yeah, it's a tough competition now. Very even, but yeah, certainly all the better to be up in the premiership. But I'll tell you what, Hawke's Bay, I love this position. Great opportunity, 5 on the line.
Two handed take makes your job easy when you're going to set a piece for a drive. Lamborn gets close, gets over, and brings up yet another try to Hawke's Bay, and that was so simple and so effective.
Oh, gee, simple it was. Tony Lamborn, I'm not sure that he expected to score it that easily himself. Beautifully taken here in the middle of the line out, dragged down, they're set for the drive. Lamborn's got in the middle with his hands on the ball now, just breaks free. Good leg drive and goes all the way.
Well, they don't come much easier. Still had a wee bit of work to do off the ball, busting through the tackle of Murphy, but toss her up on that one.
Won't you begin to guess what that means, but certainly delight, I'm sure. And that's just denied South in the bonus point they worked so hard for.
Just
Bay having banked theirs already.
Such a weapon too, Tom, isn't it? If you know, if you can get a penalty in the opposition's, say, 40-metre area, you can nudge it in and around that 5 metres from their goal line. And if you're driving from the line out, is that effective? It's pretty hard to stop.
It's nigh impossible when it's such an effective drill.
Chase.
50 games might Chase, end happily ever after for Bihar West. They got a degree more comfort if he can slot that, and that looks good from this angle and from the angle of the ARs, and two more makes it 36-22.
We have changes aplenty here. Changes for Hawke's Bay. We've got Jason Long coming on, jersey 17. Just see this good line out drive here. Again, they did it straight after the second half started. And look at that, Tony Lamborn. He loves those tries. And again, changes for South and Hawere is coming off. We've got Rutledge coming on as well. Not at first five, I can tell you.
Backwards.
Rutledge nearly got the ball bouncing in his favour. He's certainly at the first breakdown. Rabbi, who might be a little bit aggrieved he wasn't starting, has certainly played a leading hand since he's been on. Philip gets over the 22. Dowsett finds Thompson. Catch the ball first time, but that's how he can improvise.
Regathered.
He gathered it nicely. This time, Rabbi is anticipated by the defenders. Dowsett's pass. Nice shape on it. Now it's been towed through, but it's Cridge chasing. Shouldn't beat the cover. Won't. Emerson's right up there making the tackle, trying to affect a turnover. Can't do so. Towed through. We've seen it before. Ehi West beats the first player, beats the second, scores a try. Brilliant piece of individual skill.
Almost end-to-end for Hawke's Bay. They've turned defence into attack. Hassled and harried the Southland. To the ball a couple of times, and that's all it's taken. That's where the error came, the turnover. There's the first boot. And then there's just pressure on from the chase. Look at Emerson go. He's just hearing down. And he stays in it too with the tackle. Numbers arrive straight over the top. Just look for a boot here through the middle. There it is. That was the upset. Ehi West had spotted that, and we know he's got pace, and he does well to finish.
Look at that. Yeah, nearly got held back. Again, that's okay. The beauty of this new rule, isn't it? Can tow it through like that. They call it scrappy play, but Ehi West, he won't be complaining.
Well, Doubtsett might consider himself a little fortunate. Had he not scored the try, he could have found himself in a wee bit of trouble, but West wasn't phased. Now his points tally mounting. And almost sure now to be celebrating tonight both his 50th and Hawke's Bay's first win for the 2016 season. And kicking has just got better as the day's gone on for the number 10.
And it's clocking up a little bit now. Hawke's Bay really have taken the opportunities in the second half. Started it with a hiss and a roar with two in about 4 minutes.
Hang on, sorry. Capitalising now. 13.
You can see there Tony Lamborn coming 13. Off and Ben Hamlink, jersey 20, coming on for Hawke's Bay.
This is the time to empty the benches and restart. Giving a chance for Southland there, but as you see, Hamlet getting into the fray immediately. West spreading it out. Fruin taking it up. Combination that's worked well for them. Dixon, work rate phenomenal. Distribution by backs and forwards alike. Filippo doesn't want to miss out on some of the ball handling and running. West pretended, held that for an eternity. Ended up in the hands of Chui Mavavi, and Southland will come up with 7 points for sure, you think, of that angle.
Oh, well, they've got one back, Southland, and they deserve one. They've thrown plenty at it in the second half. Oh, so close on a number of occasions. Tua Mavavi's certainly been strong with ball in hand. And let's look at West. Two or three goes, thinks about it, decides to go, but no, little bit of luck. Bounced straight into his hands. Not a lot to do to finish, but Southland will be very pleased to be on that score sheet.
Well, the drop goal, which you're allowed to do, was taken by Tua Mavavi for time purposes, and he just slotted it. Just keeps that door ever so ajar.
Well, changes again, emptying all the bench pretty much at Hawke's Bay. We've got 22 Ropia going on, also Tongia going on, jersey 23.
We'll encourage Ruane McDonald as this team does not give up. The scoreline is daunting, but they just sense that maybe 4 minutes they can pull off something.
Stay up.
Get their bonus point back at the very least. It's a great thing about the bonus point system. You play till the game is over. And Eaton held up the ball, and Emerson, how good has he been this afternoon?
Stay up now, 16.
Pace and touch. Eaton. Head down. Progress forward. West, happy to just pass it on at the stage. The ball is presented and kicked through again. So this time, though, Southland have come up trumps with it. Thompson, kick, chase, could bounce for him. Has, puts it on the boot again. Player coming through. This could be a chance. Overkicked. West has scurried back and somehow saved the day. Douse it out a real
22
go at it. Maybe he should have picked it up. You, there's always that million-dollar question.
Oh, I think it was probably the right option for Douse it. He just didn't get it right on his foot. Just flicked it off to the left, and West with his pace was able to get there, but a little bit of brilliance from Jay Thompson. Chip and chase, regather it, and the speed that he then kicked through again. Yeah, he almost set up a spectacular second try within the space of minutes.
What a great player. He is in the making. Watch this.
This lovely skill off the left foot into the space. Regathers, boom, straight into the left foot again. And just have a look here. Oh, he missed it with the right foot. Maybe considering picking it up. Half gave it with the left foot, but it wasn't good enough.
Southland denied. Hawke's Bay maybe with one more chance. Ropiha takes it up. Filippo. One at a time. They get up to and over the halfway mark. All squeezed out the back. Jason Rutten's wanted to help himself, but overshot the mark. Short side probe, flick out to Garland. Puts it behind Emerson, that makes it difficult. But let the team down today, doesn't on that occasion. Now they quite content, Hawke's Bay, sucking some of these Southland defenders. As the last minute commences, they've got their bonus point. They've got their victory. They don't want to make error. They're not at the moment. It's just pick and go.
Tackle!
Protect the ball and wait till that hooter sounds. Perhaps just one more flurry for entertainment purposes. No, you'd say probably not. Victories have been so hard to come by. They've got gifted Ravi a chance, and you know what he's like when he gets a sniff. High risk passing, as you can understand at this stage of the game. Ropiha gets in
release
the way, and they start all over again with their safety play. Hawke's Bay still another 12 seconds to kill. This time we'll be more careful. Tangaeri has done well to make sure that the last action will be that of Chris Eaton, and they put it into touch.
off the boot of Opeha, complete their first victory of the season, and it's a well-deserved one indeed.
Oh, no, you can't argue with it. Hawke's Bay, they did deserve it. A victory built on probably the first 10 of the second half without their inspirational Ehiah West, who was under a yellow card at the time, but they clocked up two tries very early and went out to a good lead at that stage. They've managed to hold on, regardless from the fact that Southland hit back strongly in the second half, really grew in confidence with their attack, their continuity, continuously broke the line, but it wasn't enough, and Hawke's Bay the winners.
Let's have a chat now with Hawke's Bay captain Ash Dixon. He's with Kelvin.
Well, Ash, whatever you had at halftime in the changing room certainly did the job.
Yeah, the last, I guess, 4 to 5 games, we just haven't been coming out of the sheds good enough, and we really wanted to come at the sheds and play a bit of footy and try playing the right area of the park, and I was really proud of that today.
Yeah, when you seem to hold on to the ball for a fair bit of time, it certainly paved the way for some rewards.
I think when you hold the ball for a long time here, it's bloody hard to try to get it back, and if you're defending for a long time in the game, that last 20 minutes opens out, and you can see with the score tonight that the boys were still from both teams throwing it around, so it's quite good footy to play.
And look, third game in 8 days, it certainly takes its toll. How's your body?
Yeah, it's just holding together by a bit of tape, to be fair. I'm just pretty proud that we got our first win of the season. We've really struggled these last few weeks, and I'm just stoked that we managed to get a W under the belt. So, we can try and move forward from here and build a bit of confidence and, take a couple of days off, have a bit of a breather.
Hey, that's good. Well, look, all the best for the rest of the competition.
It's good to get a win, and a win on the road too for Hawke's Bay. It was hard earned. Just every time they looked to be dominating the match, Southland came back. They found something a little bit extra when it counted. Braden Mitchell now with Kelvin.
Hey, well, Braden, Hawani's been harping on your coach about consistency, and it is getting better, isn't it?
It is getting a wee bit better. Just same old story. The last sort of 20, we're up at halftime again, and then they come out firing. A simple mistake sort of cost us. And then credit to them, they've had a tough turnaround, and I don't think the results really reflect how good a team they are, actually.
Yeah, one thing we talk about, they have got a wealth of super experience. They've got a lot of players, a fair bit that have played a lot of rugby. You guys, you hate to say it, but it probably is a rebuilding phase, isn't it?
Yeah, like you say, hate to say it, and they're a top quality side. They've got a lot of good names in their side, and like I said before, I don't think the results really show what kind of top quality side they are.
And Bay of Plenty on Wednesday, game we talk about it, 4 games, 15 days. How do you train for that? What's the plan?
Just more recovery mode, and I guess at the end of the day, we play footy, so if we're playing, it's more fun than training. So, yeah, good to get out there and play, I suppose.
Yeah, I'm all for that. Love to play, not train. All right, mate, best of luck for
Thank
the next week.
Much.
I'm sure the Stags will find some positives out of this game. It's a positive result, though, for Hawke's Bay. So if we take a break here, they're the victors, 43-29. Bay came into this match as firm favourites, but by no means had everything their own way. As you can see, Southland scoring 29 points kept Hawke's Bay honest, and at times were level on the scoreboard. Just a purple patch in the second half meant Hawke's Bay could pounce and score those tries to rack up their bonus point. Brad Webber was the star of the day, one of the many stars. Let's have a chat with him.
Well, Brad, must be great coming back down here and playing Jimmy Cowan, is it?
Yeah, Jimmy's probably my favourite player to play against, actually. I've loved every time I've played against him. He's a great man, and it brings a lot of nigga and a bit of chat, and I love that, so it's pretty cool.
And talking of great players, Ehiah West outside of you, how good is it having Ehiah?
Oh, it's brilliant. We've played a lot together through high school and that, so he's one of my best mates growing up, so it's great to see him play 50 games for the Magpies, and he deserved this one.
Yeah, it's fantastic. And also, you weren't on the game when you played Canterbury, probably thankfully you'll be thankful, but this is a great comeback for you guys, isn't it?
Yeah, well, a lot didn't go right for us on Sunday against Canterbury, and we had a lot of wrongs to put right, and I thought we did that tonight. It was brilliant.
Hey, well done tonight. Enjoy the rest of the week.
He'll enjoy his night. We'll enjoy another look at the try scored and Brad Webber, the first of them. JP, how slick was this?
Yeah, slick, slick movement it certainly was. You've only got to give this guy a wee bit of room and space and he will cut you to pieces.
They could score both in the backs and in the forwards. A couple of well-executed line-out drives. This is the first of them. Dixon, the captain, over the line.
Yeah, just too easy, wasn't it? The first opportunity there. And then they broke away. Hawke's Bay with little space again. And it was Garland this time, the man from fullback, who looked dangerous, and he finished it.
Southland were keeping in touch through the boot of Hawera with some nicely struck penalties. But what about this? Playing under advantage, the kick, the catch by Emerson, and completing the act.
And then another line-out drive. And the inspirational this evening, Lamborn, Tony Lamborn, certainly deserved that one. And finally, Ehiah West broke away from a kick, saw the opportunity again, a man with pace, and he was the finisher.
Well, West is, of course, having his 50th, and no doubt a big smile to go with it. He talks to Calvin.
Well, Ehiah, 50 games, how does that feel for you?
Yeah, it's obviously pretty cool. But, to be honest, it snuck off me. I wasn't really keeping count, and didn't know I was even close, so it's pretty cool. I was stoked when I played my first one for the Magpies. You know, I've born and bred in Hawke's Bay, so I love the province, and to get 50 is pretty special, and it's pretty cool.
And, I mean, you've got some potent power on that back line, the likes of Lowe, you've got Fruin, and you've got some nice young guys coming up through you, like Emerson and the likes.
Yeah, we've got a pretty exciting young back line, and it's just about trying to, you know, get the ball and try and score tries when we can. And, you know, we've struggled this year. We haven't really clicked, but, you know, if we keep working at it, keep encouraging these young fellas, I'm sure we'll get there by the end of the season.
Yeah, look, and the forward plaque tonight, they set a pretty good platform for you boys to attack off. Line-out seemed to go well for you.
Yeah, they've been awesome most of the season. You know, we've got some big boys up there, likes of Ben, Big Bama, and Ricky Riccatelli. They love a scrum, so it's awesome when we see the scrum going forward and give us some front foot ball like that.
Hey, look, congratulations on your 50th. Great effort.
Awesome, cheers.
Yes, more games to come for Hawke's Bay, of course, and still a faint hope for semi-finals, perhaps. But let's have a look at the stats for the whole game, JP. Do they tell a truer story than they did at halftime?
Well, certainly. I mean, look at that position again. I mean, Hawke's Bay totally dominated position right throughout the match. First half, they were up around 70-odd%, so evened out a little bit there. But time in opposition 22, they had so many opportunities. They managed to take enough to win the match. And then if we have a look right down the bottom, Southland, I mean, the first half, 70-odd tackles, clocked up plenty in the second half as well. And, you know, they really showed great attitude tonight. Some excellent attack in the second half too, but couldn't quite do the job.
122 tackles made. They'll be feeling that tomorrow morning once they rest up after a hard evening's work. Let's see what's happening around the rugby scene this weekend. We've got Counties of Manukau. Look, a one-point difference with Taranaki just keeping their nose ahead. And then Southland pushing Hawke's Bay all the way, but outclassed in the end. Coming up on Friday, 5:40, double-headed, of course, because it's Test Match weekend. We've got Tasman hosting Northland at Trafalgar Park in Nelson. At Friday at 7:30, Wellington play Bay of Plenty at the Westpac Stadium. And then Saturday at 2:30, Otago hosting North Harbour. It's a 7:40 kickoff, by the way, on Friday. And on Saturday, 4:30, Manawatu Canterbury is the warm-up for the Test match. And Manawatu playing Canterbury, who are playing in a level of their own at the moment. But can they be toppled by the Turbos? We shall wait and see. There's plenty more to come on Sunday at 2:30, Auckland County's Manukau, a great local derby, and then Waikato taking on Taranaki in Hamilton, in what is also a derby of sorts, at 4:30 on Sunday. That's a Ramfleet Shield match, of course, which Waikato currently hold. We've got the Test match. JP, you're looking forward to both of these, surely?
Oh, absolutely. In fact, I'm going to the first one. I'd be like to go to the second one as well, but that'd be tricky.
You got a free ticket, too, haven't you? You got a free ticket.
I have, yeah. It's not the only reason I'm going, Tom, but obviously New Zealand in incredible form at the moment. South Africa bring a different dimension, so we'll see what they come up with on the night, but certainly looking forward to it.
And that's a reunion of All Blacks. Tell the fans about that.
Yes, that's right. The night before, the Friday night, there's a reunion of 1996 tour. We went over there and managed to win a series in South Africa.
Right. It's well worth celebrating. We might see where the standings are at the moment as we look at the Premiership, and it'll be No second guessing as to who is top. Canterbury well ahead at the moment, but Taranaki, Auckland, Waikato all have prospects of semi-final action. Counties Manukau knocking on the door. Hawke's Bay just keeping their season alive. And of course, Otago completely dominating the championship standings. Wellington, Manawatu, Bay of Plenty in the box seat for the playoffs. But here at Invercargill's Rugby Park Stadium, Hawke's Bay with the victors tonight by 43-29.
This has been a presentation of Fox Sports.